Hey everybody and welcome back to my channel. My name is Teresa and today I wanted to do a full review on the new Mugler perfume Angel & Elixir. But before I jump into this video, please make sure you are subscribed to this channel so you always notified about new releases, and give this video a thumbs up. Let's go ahead and jump right in. Okay, so Mugler came out with a new alien flanker. Some people said they discontinue, and there's a motorcycle passing right now. Perfect timing. Somebody said they discontinued the original Angel, which I don't think so. I don't think they would get rid of it within the next 100-200 years, and I've still seen it everywhere. But yeah, they came out with a new flanker, and I have gotten the travel size because this perfume is expensive. And if you've been watching my channel, I own around 75 perfumes right now, which is a lot, and I told myself I will only get a 1 ounce bottle or 1.6 fluid ounces, not the big bottle anymore. So I was like, you know what? Perfect timing, picking up the travel size. We can try it out because it's nowhere. I couldn't find it anywhere in stores. So I saw this on Mercari for around $20 for, what is it, 10 milliliters or 0.33 fluid ounces. And I was like, yeah, let me try it out because the notes on Fragrantica look really, really good. People said, you know what, let's keep all that a secret. So let's go over the price, okay? So let's go over the price. Like I said, this is a pricey perfume. They have, which you never really see, a 0.80 fluid ounces. Then they also have a 1.7 fluid ounces and a 3.3 fluid ounces. The 3.3 fluid ounces is $185. 1.7 is $150. And the smallest one, which you don't even get a full ounce, is $95. Like I said, it's very, very expensive in my opinion for a designer perfume. I do like the original Angel. I do like it. I think it's very appropriate for winter though. I did have the Angel Muse in the past. I do have Alien. I have Alien Goddess Intense. So I really like the house. Usually everything they come out with, I do enjoy. And let's go ahead and talk about the notes. I have it right here. So the main accords are white, floral, vanilla. Like if I see those two, it's usually something I like. Woody, sweet, yellow floral, powdery, amber, balsamic, and soft spicy. And then in the top you have pink pepper, which sometimes can be hit and miss for me because pink pepper can tickle my nose a little bit, and sometimes I can't enjoy the perfume. Then in the mid you have jasmine, ylang ylang, orange blossom, sandalwood, and in the base you have bourbon, vanilla, and amber extreme, which is like a molecule or something like that, which I've never really seen before. And my bangs are still driving me crazy. So I have seen, I think, one or two reviews on YouTube, because I always like to watch a review before I purchase a perfume, and people said it smells really similar to YSL Black Opium, and it's a very, very sweet generic designer perfume. Most of the people on Fragrantica are bashing this perfume left and right. Not a lot of people say like, oh, this is really nice. And people compare it to the Alien Goddess Intense, which I personally own and I absolutely love it. It's like my top three perfumes. They also compare it to Valentino, Donna Born, and Roma. And a lot of people, like I said, compare it to YSL Black Opium. I don't see the Black Opium. I do see the Alien Goddess Intense. Right now I'm smelling it right here, and it has like a little bit of a lactonic vibe to it. And I just filmed another review about the Ariana Grande perfume, and I'm wearing a lot right now. So let's just keep it going. So this is, in my opinion, it is a very strong perfume. And let me have it sit here for a little bit. So people say, the notes say in the top you have pink pepper, which I get a little bit. And I love the opening of this perfume. Like, this was a blind buy whenever I first bought it, and I was like, oh my god, I can't, this is so good, I need the big bottle. Oh crap, now it's so good, I need the big bottle. And it is, like I said, the opening is a little bit lactonic in my opinion. I do get that whatever I love so much in the Alien Goddess Intense, which is the Amber, I think, which there's no Amber, well, there's Amber Extreme listed, but I do get that. But whenever it really like dries down, is fully dried down, I can smell a little bit of Carolina Herrera Good Girl, the original one, and Coach Dreams Sunset. Coach Dream Sunset and Carolina Herrera Good Girl, it's like a tongue twister, they smell really similar to me. And whenever this dries down, I get that. And that base of that perfume can be very overwhelming in my opinion. This is definitely not something I would wear during the hot summer months. Maybe in the evening, you know, if you go out. But it's definitely a winter, fall winter perfume, in my opinion. In my humble opinion. And is it generic or something that has been done before? Probably, but I really like it. I really like it. I will not get the big bottle for now because usually those travel sizes, they will last me for quite a while. And that's, I'm sorry, I'm making so much noise. I don't need to hold it in the camera the whole time. And but yeah, those travel sizes usually last me for a very long time. People say the longevity is weak on it. I have to disagree on it. It lasted for hours on my arm and I kept getting whiffs of it. And I was just putting on one spray, so that tells you something. But I've been also gotten a lot more sensitive to perfumes. I used to overspray. I used to probably spray like 20 to 25 sprays of perfume. Even of perfumes like La Vie Belle, the original Lancome, La Vie Belle, where you think you don't need, you really don't need more than two or three. So I've gotten a lot more sensitive to stronger perfumes. So sometimes people, they get nose blind if they constantly smell perfumes. But I do smell perfumes pretty much every day. And to me, it is a very strong perfume. Definitely not something I would wear in an office, a work environment. I would not wear that. I would definitely wear it for date night, evening, going out for dinner. Yeah, it's very sexy in my opinion. I really don't like to say that word for some reason, but I do like it a lot. And I don't think it is blind buy worthy in my opinion. I would say definitely check out a smaller size or see if you can smell it in the stores. Yes, it is a very generic celebrity perfume, celebrity designer perfume. But I've really just gotten like, don't blind buy anything. Get a travel size, sample it first. Because I've bought so many perfumes in my life blindly, and I'm like, just don't do it anymore. Almost bought Billie Eilish, the original, the golden one that everyone is crazy about. Because like everybody's like, oh my god, it smells so good, it smells so good, it smells so good. And I just realized I don't like chocolate in perfumes. Where a lot of people are like, are you crazy around like chocolate perfumes? And I've noticed I just don't like it. It doesn't smell good on my skin. On my skin, it smells like mentholy. I don't know if, like menthol. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. Like almost like mouthwash in a way. So anyway, I do like it. But in the very, very deep dry down, you get that. I think that's what I can smell is the Amber Extreme, which is... Let me look up that that note. Amber Extreme Group Musk Amber and Enamelic Smells. Let me see if I can show you guys. Like, it looks like a molecule, kind of. So yeah, this is what it looks like. Anyway, I hope this review was helpful to you if you are wanting to try this perfume out. Like I said, it just recently came out. I just got it on the Ulta website. And yeah, my bangs are looking weird again. I hope you're having a wonderful day, and maybe I will see you next time. Bye.